Hey guys, this is the Red Dropship by Kin Software. I didn't know they actually made a dropship like this one. I've never seen this on any of the scenarios, so I'm not sure. Like, I'm not sure if this is even used in a scenario. I'm gonna finish the workaround here. Oh yeah, I'm testing out a new outfit by the way. So this vehicle costs 5,204 PCO with 1,113 blocks. Yeah, keeping it fresh for the ship showcase with my new dress. Alright, let's see here. So this vehicle actually use upgrades for the thrusters. I feel like this is the only Kin Software vehicle that use like upgrades. I'm not sure if they use scripts or not on this vehicle though. This is an interesting configuration. By the way, they are using piston and a hinge here. And a rotor. No, that's another hinge up there. We got some backward thrusters and a large forward thruster. Hydrogen thrusters here on the back of the nacelle. And, well, of the wing. Some ion thrusters here, so this vehicle has like all three propulsion types. Are those thrust vectoring thrusters? Yeah, I guess these are thrust vectoring thrusters using subgrids. And that's really interesting. We got some static thrusters here as well. Same thing on the other side of the ship here. So the ship is only armed with two Gatling guns on the wings. A single asymmetrical spotlight to the front of the ship. Then some more extra thrusters to the front of the ship here. To the top of the vehicle. Some thrusters, some batteries, and I like how they texture this vehicle by the way. They made it rather simple, but also efficient in how they want to convey what they want to convey with the painting of the vehicle. Did that phrase even make sense? What is this thing? Wait, what? Hey, that's not right. That's not supposed to be able to go there. What's going on here? Never mind, it's from the interior light in there. And finally, to the bottom of the vehicle. No landing gear or magnetic plate down here. We do have these bits of the armor here, but well, I'm guessing this is some kind of a static. No, this is just part of the doorway. A single connector, some more thrusters, and these are the reactors of the ship. Alright, that's pretty much the whole exterior. Let's check the interior. I kind of went inside the interior earlier. This is a rather questionable height here. The step on this doorway is too tall for people to just walk in, but it's also too short for people to jump on it. So you get to use your jetpack. Hydrogen tanks to the back of the vehicle. Air fender. Gyroscope. I like how a lot of the internal components are repairable from inside the ship, so you know, that's gonna be useful in some multi-crew combat situations. I'm guessing this is the access to the connector down there. Passenger seats here and some fake button panels. Yeah, this vehicle, I mean this interior is actually rather bare bone, especially compared to some of the things that are in the workshop these days. Maybe this is like one of their older builds. I'm gonna close the doors. And well, some timers here, programmable block, and that's the bridge of the vehicle. So this is like a dropship, right? Then we can carry two passenger sitting on these chairs. Then maybe we can carry two people in here. Then maybe another three people here and three more here. That's like a total of 10 passengers. We're gonna test it later. I'm just gonna fly the ship for now. Those are the toolbar controls. An unmarked timer block. Whoa. Vital mode. That's pretty cool actually. The handling of this vehicle is actually rather nice actually. Like the vehicle, accelerates rather quickly. Can that vital? No, that vital cannot be used to stop the vehicle by going backward. Hold on. I guess we can always do something like this. Yeah, that's gonna be very useful, especially considering this ship's role as like a dropship. This is something that I noticed before though when I was flying the ship, is that, well, the vehicle is kind of clangy when you're flying the vehicle because of the subgrids configuration. So that's just something to keep in mind there. Stop the vehicle. Let's see if this can actually carry 10 passengers, hold on. If the vehicle is parked this way, you can actually just walk inside the vehicle and get inside, soldiers. I'm gonna put myself in the pilot seat first before filling up the vehicle. You gotta play a little bit of Tetris while filling this vehicle with people, by the way, because you don't want to fill up this doorway before you fill up the front of the vehicle. Otherwise, people won't be able to get inside anymore. Yeah, there we go. My initial calculation was accurate. We can carry 10 passengers in here. Can we still fly though? Yeah, we still fly just fine. I'm still not sure how to use those vector thrusters on the back of the vehicle. The vehicle does feel a little bit more sluggish to drive to, I mean to fly to, when you have all those passengers inside. I'm gonna switch the game mode to survival for the drop test of the vehicle. Ooh, that's a really steep hill. Alright, let's see how well the ship can go downhill. Come on. Ooh, there goes the thrusters. Whoa. We're still fine in. Look at all those people. Oof. Oh, wait a second. I got thrown out of the vehicle. Well. How many people survived the fall? We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people in here. So we lost like 4 passengers. Yeah, that was a pretty dramatic crash there. Look at all the damage. Is this thing still flyable? Hold on. I'm just gonna put this here. We're actually still flyable. Small grid vehicles are just so resilient to voxel collision impact damage. I guess we can actually carry one more passenger back here. I'm still only carrying 10 people back there though. Alright, are you guys ready? Let's see how well this vehicle can insert troops into enemy base. Oh, I forgot to make myself targetable again. I'll try one more time. Make sure I don't forget to make myself targetable again. Alright, here we go again. This should be going a lot better than before because I know how to handle this vehicle even more now. So we're gonna wait until all the artillery turrets, have fired. I'm gonna try to, we still need to wait for the artillery turret to shoot one more time here. Then we can safely land. We also need to make sure. Oh no. Hold on. Getting closer. Hold on. I can still wiggle closer to the enemy base. Come on. We're still getting. Oh no. Well, in actual situations, all the troops will just get outside, right? So technically. Technically, this mission is a success. Hold on. Come on. That actually went a lot worse than the first try. How many people did we lose on that one? There's no one else there. Wait, where's all the survivors? Wait, what? For some reason, the people that we got out of the vehicle, they didn't survive as well. That's weird. Well, I mean, I'm guessing this is mostly just a vehicle for fun because we have like subgrids and stuff, which makes the handling of the vehicle not that great either. I'm guessing maybe Kin Software just want to use this vehicle to demonstrate subgrid and scripts though. And when we look at it from that purpose, this kind of makes sense. This vehicle is from the Sparks of the Future update, by the way. I just noticed what the SOTF stands for. I don't think we have like any survival kit and stuff in here. We do have a single O2H2 generator though, so this vehicle can kind of refuel itself. So, you know, this is definitely not the most efficient dropship that you can make on Space Engineers, but well, That's not the main point of the vehicle. Say, that's the red sparks of the future, dropshipped by Kin Software. You guys can find the link in the description below. What a tragedy.